Hey guys, it's Colin Smith here, and this week I've got two tutorials for you. What I'm going to show you here is to create a text effect where we're going to put a metal edge around our text and then fill it with this lumpy, glassy kind of a thing. It's kind of fun, I think you're going to enjoy it. Alright, so what we're going to do is, because I've had some people say, hey, you got all these photography things you're doing, you got all these drone things you're doing, what about designers? Don't worry, I haven't forgotten designers. So this week I've got a technique just for designers. I'm going to show you how to take text and add this metallic edge around it, a nice chromey kind of metal, and then we're going to put a texture in it and put a shiny kind of a glassy thing, but we're going to make the glassy thing kind of a little bit, I don't really know how to say it, just kind of this weird shape texture. There it is. It looks right there. So I think there's a lot of different things that you're going to learn from this. And one of the things you're going to learn, one of the key things, apart from creating this effect, is how to create a layer style and actually make that layer style fit any size. Because when you add a layer style to something big and it was designed for that, it looks great. You add it to something small, it just looks weird, like hand-me-down clothes that you haven't quite grown into yet. So I've got some techniques in here that are going to show you how to adjust and modify any layer style to work. I'm also going to give you this pattern, and I'm also going to give you these two layer styles that I've created in this tutorial. So just look at the link underneath or the little link up here, and you can download those and use them for yourself. So without further ado, let's jump in and do this text effect. All right, I've just taken a little bit of a break from writing my drone photography book to get a tutorial up for you guys. And I'm going to do something different this week that I haven't done in a while. I'm going to give you this really photorealistic type of type effect. So I'm going to create this kind of glossy, bubbly, glossy thing with a texture in the background that sits on this metal kind of a shape. I think you're going to enjoy it. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new document. And I'm just, this one's 1280 by 720. Just something to fill up your space. And, you know, it can be any size you want. I'm also going to grab a font here. Let's go to the type tool. And what I'm going to do is set like a mid-gray for this. There we go. A lot of the time when you do these type of effects, it's great to start with a gray color, because then that way you can use blend modes a lot more freely and just, you know, gives you a little bit more flexibility. So I'm going to click OK, because I'm actually going to add the color in the layer style. So gray just is a really great neutral color to start with. Anyway, I'm using this font here. This is a BD, something like that. You know, you could use Arial Black or whatever. Actually, let's grab the Arial Black. I think I like that one better. Just something that's blocky. And I'm just going to click here and type in. I can see this is way too big. I'm going to do Photoshop Cafe as two words. And to select everything, just click with your type tool and hit Control A. That would be Command A on Mac. And you can go here and change the size of it. Because that was just humongously way too big. The leading is way too far apart. So let's go here and we're just going to change this leading. That's that one there. And we just kind of pull them together a little bit. But before I commit to that, I'm going to go large with this. So notice the type is still selected. I'm just kind of playing around with it. Finding something I like. Let's do this. This will be kind of interesting. And then I'm going to go back to my leading again and just play around with that. All right, looks good. Click the move tool to apply that. And there we go. We've got this big, huge, blocky thing on here. Now, I have a feeling that we might have to change some things here because the Photoshop and the cafe are actually going to be different. So this is great. You're actually going to learn something new here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to rasterize this real quick. And the reason I'm doing that is just because these are different sizes and I want to separate them. So I'm just going to select the first part here, the Photoshop on the top, and I'm going to move this to a new layer. So if you hit Control and not Control J or Command J, but add the Shift key. So I'm doing Command Shift J and it'll be Control Shift J. And what that does is rather than copy to a layer, it moves it to a new layer. So now we've got these on two separate layers. Now there is a reason for this, and that's because this type, when I create this layer style, it's gonna look good on a big type, but it's gonna look horrible on the small type. So I'm also gonna show you how to make one size fit all. So we're gonna concentrate on the cafe part, and then we're gonna apply it to the Photoshop part and make it look good. I've seen people apply these layer styles and it looks hideous on type because it's not designed for the right size of type. So I'm going to show you at the very end, you're going to see how to resolve that and make any layer style work on any type. So anyway, now that we've got that, I'm going to create this layer style. So I'm going to go into the layer style effect here, and I'm going to go down to patterns. I want to add a pattern over the top of this. We're going to click the pattern overlay. And what have I got here? I've got my diagonal line here. If you want this, this pattern does not come with Photoshop by default. If you want to find the patterns, click on here. You can see all the patterns. And you can click on here to load all the different patterns in that come with Photoshop. This here is one that I created. Be happy to share it with you. Just click the link beneath to go grab it. All right, so what we're going to do with this is, let's play around with the scaling. Do we want to scale it a little bit bigger? Yeah, maybe like that. Looks pretty cool. And I don't like the way it interacts. It just feels a little much. But before we do that, what we're going to do is we're going to create an overlay. Rather than giving it a solid color, I'm going to go into a gradient. And you can see here, you can click on the gradient editor. This top part here, adjust the opacity. And the bottom part there, adjust the color. So I'm going to actually play around with the opacity. I'm going to drop it down a little bit. And I don't like this color, so I just click there on a swatch. And let's find a more interesting blue. Ah, I like that one better. Doesn't feel so hokey. Let's click on this one. Or you can double click to open the color swatch. So let's play around with one that is going to be a little bit more, you know, aqua kind of a color. That's just a little much. Let's play around there. I like that. There's a nice interaction that's going on. Click OK. And now what I want to do though is change the, because notice this is kind of going across at an angle. I just want this to go up and down. So if I change that, it'll do it. And we can change the scale too. Notice if I make the scale very low, see how it changes right there? As I increase that scale, it creates a smoother gradient across there. All right, that's pretty awesome. So that's our layer style to start with. Let's go back to a pattern overlay now and see if we can make it blend a little nicer. So what have we got here? How's the overlay look? Looks like someone just drew over the top of it. It's too strong. The soft light's not bad, actually. But I'm just going to take the opacity down a little more because I want to make this pattern not so solid, but make it a little bit more, you know, just kind of blend it in. So, all right, that looks good. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to add the metallic effect to the background. So let's just go back under the effects here, and we're going to do that right now. Now, we're going to add the sheen, the glossy sheen at the very end. So what we're going to do here is we're going to do the background here. So I want to create some kind of a, you know, a metal edge. So I'm going to do that for stroke. So I'm going to create this stroke here, and I'm going to make it a little bigger. Actually, we changed the size here. I was changing the scale. I apologize. So let's change the size up there a little bit. Position should be outside. Blend mode is normal. And we've chosen a gradient here for the fill type. And in the gradient I'm using is just a black to white gradient. So we're just going to hit the OK key. And you can see what we've got going there. Now, what we're going to do with this now is we want it. I'm going to bring that scale back to 100 because I don't even know what that's going to do. It's going to mess something up. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add the stroke on it. So we're going to choose Bevel and Emboss. And notice immediately it looks good. And that's because it remembers my last settings. So let's have a look here. What have we set here? We set it to a stroke emboss. Because if any other type of emboss, it doesn't do anything on the stroke, except we go up here, we change it to a stroke emboss. I've got it to smooth. I've turned that depth all the way up. And let's play around with the size a little bit more, get it better. Kind of like it there. So I pushed it up a little bit. I'm not going to soften it. Notice I'm using this contour here. You can try different ones. But a lot of the time, this particular one here, I like this shape one. It gives a glossy metallic effect. And then what we're going to do is go into contour. And notice the contour really makes a snap. Make sure anti-alias is turned on. So we could try the same kind of thing here if you want that same type of effect. Or we can play around with the different ones. I kind of like this one because it makes it look like we're cutting out the edges. I really like that. And then what we're going to do is give this one a little bit of a drop shadow here. So we're just going to turn on drop shadow. And notice that the color here for the drop shadow has changed to blue. let's change it to more of this aqua color and see how it just kind of makes it look like it's a bit more glossy. Just black would make it look like, you know, typical drop shadow, but this makes it look like it's just a little bit semi-transparent. So let's bring that down a little bit, and you can kind of see how that's looking. Now we're going to, you know, give this glossy effect at the top, once again at the very end. So see how that's not bad. We're pretty close. So what I want to do now is I'm going to create the next part of the effect, and I'm going to do this on both of these layers at the same time. So what I'm going to do is actually just hit control click, and that selects this area. And I'm going to do the same for there. So we've got all of this selected. So what I'm going to do is create a new layer on top. And then I'm just going to take this layer, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill it with white. So control backspace fills that with white. If we hide the background, you can see what we've done. Awesome. So I'm going to hit the alt key and just drag around here to turn off the bottom one. So I just want to work with this top one for now. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to contract this. I'm going to choose select, modify, contract. Now the reason I selected these separately, by the way, I'm going to make this 8, is because once again, this is smaller and it's going to have a different effect than the other one, which is larger. So I want to make sure it kind of balances a little bit. So what I'm going to need to do now is I'm going to inverse the selection. So I'm going to choose select inverse. And now I've got select inverse. I'm going to choose to select, and then we're going to go down here and we're going to feather this. Now, if you remember, we contracted it by 8. I want to feather it by about double. So we're going to do 16, click OK. Now, when I hit the delete key, something interesting is going to happen. I'm going to hit Control D. So what it did is it just kind of let this go in the middle like that. And it disappeared around the edges. So just kind of, we're just getting a little bit of that white in the middle. Now we're going to do the same thing for this part of the text. So let's just hide the background. And we can, you know, even hide everything else so you can see what's going on. Actually, you know what? I just deleted that cafe. That's fine. I'm just going to control click on cafe. And then we're going to just do the same thing. I'm going to create a new layer. I'm hiding the background, by the way. Fill that with white by hitting the control backspace key. Fills it with white. Now we're going to do the same thing we did before. Select, contract, modify, contract. This time I'm going to do it by 12, say. Okay, that looks good. And we're going to select inverse. Let's do select inverse here. So we're going the other way now. And now we want to feather this. So we're going to choose modify feather. And we're going to do the same thing you do with the contract. As we're going to make it 24, we're going to do about double. Click OK. And now hit the delete key. And I'm just going to turn this off. Control D. All right, so you see we've got this Photoshop Cafe thing here. Let me invert the background so you can see it. So what we've done is we've just created this kind of a shape here. This is going to be our glossy reflection effect. And you'll see how this is going to work in a second. I'll turn everything else back on. And let's put this one back to white. So what we're going to do is with that layer, see there it is there, we've selected this. We're just going to add a layer style to it. So we're just going to go to select here. We're going to go to layer style. Give it a bevel and emboss. Now let's see what kind of emboss we're going to give this one. I'm going to try a pillow emboss, and we're going to turn the depth all the way up. Let's turn the size down a little bit, and we could soften that if we wanted. But see how we're just kind of playing around with this, and one of the things you might want to do is turn the opacity down on, actually turn the opacity all the way up on screen and turn it down there a little bit. We're just trying to balance this to kind of create this little kind of a textury effect here. And let's go into contour, and we're going to turn that contour on. That looks good. And let's change the size of this a little bit. Just want to get this to work. So that's quite small right now. We've got that at 2. And that's looking good. All right, so how do we transfer this effect here from this layer onto the other layer? Well, I'm going to show you right now. I'm going to grab the one I did for the cafe. I'm going to drag this into Photoshop. So I'm going to hit the Option key or the Alt key, and click on effects, drag it into that type. Notice it copies it, but look at this. It's a little big, it looks weird. That's okay. This is how we fix it. Right click on effects there. This is on our layer here, we want to shrink it down. Right click on effects and then choose scale effects. So under the scale effects, we can just pull it down a little bit until it looks better. Now I'm thinking about there looks pretty good. That looks even better. Okay, so notice now that that fits that. Let's do the same thing for this overlay wrappy thing that we've done. I know that's a very technical term. So let's take the effect. We're going to Option, click on there, and drag it into there. So now we've got that same effect on the top part. Once again, do the same thing. Click on effects, right click, scale effects. So we're going to take this and pull it down a little bit. And we'll get this where it's going to look good because it just needs to be small. There we go. And that's about 30% there. Click OK. And this still feels a little bit thick. So let's go back under there, right click, scale these effects, and bring it down a little bit more. Whoops, hang on. Make sure we got the right one there. There we go. Go down and we're going to scale the effects and pull them down a little bit more until it looks good. There we go. That's nice. Click OK. And there we go. We've created this cool kind of a style here. So here's just kind of a cool type effect here. And what I'm going to do just to save you a bunch of time is I'm actually going to create this into a layer style. So let me go under here. You got two layer styles here. You got the first one for the type. That's that one. If I just click here, it's going to convert it to a layer style. You know, I was going to call it thingy, but why don't I call it metal? Metal edges, okay? So there we go. Boom. We've got that one with metal edges on it. And then what about the glossy effect? It's kind of, I don't know what to call that. It's kind of a bubbly thing. Okay, so we're going to do this. We'll call it bubbly sheen. So why don't we go to the styles there, click here, and we're going to save that one. Bubbly Sheen is Charlie Sheen's brother. All right, so what I'm going to do then is I'm going to give you these layer styles, just that same link. I'm going to give you the texture. I'm going to give you the two layer styles. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. All right, I hope you enjoyed this. It's been a while since I did a text effect. If you want me to do more text effects, let me know. If you want me to do more kind of 3D-ish kind of designery effects, let me know in the comments underneath. And I'm here to serve, here to please. So whatever you want to learn, let me know. And like a genie, I'll pull it out of the bottle and I'll do it for you. Well, if it can be done, of course, within reason. All right, so anyway, thanks. Hit that subscribe button because I've got new tutorials coming all the time. I need you to subscribe so that you can get these tutorials. If you don't hit the subscribe button and you don't become a subscriber, how are you going to know I've got a new tutorial? You won't. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Until next time, don't forget, hit that like button if you like this. I would really appreciate that.